Good morning, everyone. We from SMK Section 3 Bandar Tenggara today would love to explain about our innovation, the Universal Suture, or more affectionately called the US Suture. Now, let me give you a little bit of a preface from where this innovation came from. Well, it was from our classmate's idea. He kept on ranting about that life is unfair, and he kept on saying this after our language lessons. To a point, we just asked him, why? Why do you keep on complaining? Is there any reason? His reason was totally unexpected. It was because of the furniture in the language room. Well, the furniture was this common, this normal student chair. From looking at it, it doesn't look any different, right? It's perfect. But the twist over here is, our friend is left-handed. And if you realize, there's no support. There's no support at all. A table, an armchair, none at all. So he had no choice but to contort his body in a very uncomfortable manner in order to be able to use the table. And from here we realized, further research must be done. So we conducted a survey, and for our school itself. From there, we got to know that from each class, there was at least about 1 to 2 people who were left-handed. This was truly astounding. These people were struggling every day just because of this chair, and this creates an inconducive learning environment. Well, we have taken matters into our own hands to overcome this, and Kaiman will explain further about this.
Alright, thank you, Liva. Alright, as we all know, 10% of the world's population consists of left-handed people. Now, whoever invented this chair over here, apparently they thought that 10%, that is 800 million people, were negligible. So, we don't believe in that. We think otherwise. We believe that everyone deserves to receive an education in a conducive environment. So, that brings us to our first function over here, is that our innovation includes a table for left-handed students. So regardless of whether or not you're left or right-handed, you get to have a comfortable environment whenever you're studying. Now let me have a seat here. As you can see, the tables can be kept open for when you want to take a seat and closed for when you want to work. Now, this is already better than the other chair, even when you disregard the left and right-handed inequality issue, and it's that there's more work surface area in general. This means that if you're right-handed, maybe you can put your reference book on the left and your notebook on the right, and vice versa. In general, you have more space to work with, and that's better than when you're taking notes or listening to your teacher. Now, I think I know what you're thinking. What is this strange piece behind our chair? You don't see this on the back of many chairs, do you? There's none of them. So this is actually a podium to assist our students during presentations. Now, during this age of 21st century learning, presentations are a very common occurrence in the classroom. The students have to manage their presentation on their own, so whenever they have a script to read, or maybe they have props they want to use to express themselves, they have to hold it, and that could be a bit cumbersome. So we have decided to make it a bit more convenient by providing a podium, a platform for them to put their things on, so that they may use their full body and spirit to express their emotions and thought processes during their presentation. Now, maybe you're thinking, what is this white sheet doing here? And for that, I'll be leaving it to Liva to explain to you.
Alright, thank you, Kaiwen. This white sheet over here is actually a whiteboard, a magnetic one. But look at this, it's a special feature to it. It's detachable. Why is it detachable, you ask? We have a metal layer underneath that allows it to stick. Okay. Its main function, this detachable magnetic board, is a brainstorming platform. You gotta understand, what I would say, presentations are the it thing now. So, to allow us to pour our ideas into this one paper, this one sheet, makes it very efficient. Once you've laid out your ideas, for example, thank you. So, you just lay out your idea, write a topic on it, you're done. Your notes are, everything's over here. Don't waste your time rewriting the notes. Instead, you just lift it and just stick it on the whiteboard. So attach that and you can get immediately to presenting. This makes the the whole presentation process very much efficient and enjoyable. Alright, that's all the functionalities. Now, I pass it to Yusuf to give a little bit of introduction on the IoT part.
Thank you, Liva. So, IoT. This chair is already an IoT. Why? Because of this thing. We have attached a system to this chair. So, now, some of you must be wondering, what is IoT? So, IoT is a short form for Internet of Things. It is interaction or communication of two devices that send signals to each other. with network over the internet. Okay, so IoT is a very powerful technology in this century. It is can reevaluate our daily life. So let me give you an example. So let's imagine that you are a student in a classroom. So you don't understand the lessons. You want to raise your hand and tell the teacher that you don't understand, but you're afraid because you feel ashamed of yourself because you think that you are the only students who don't understand the lessons. So you don't want to raise your hand and tell the teacher that you don't understand. But meanwhile, in the point of view of teachers wants to help you. Teachers want to help you to understand the lessons if you don't understand and help you. So we create this system, which is IoT, to help to solve this problem, to help students and teachers in their class. So now you guys must be wondering, how does it work, how does it function? So I will leave it to Liva for the functions.
Alright, what I'll be doing is a very short demo on how it works. Just gonna stop this. Alright, thank you. Well, you see there are two buttons over here. I'm just gonna give you a short example. I'm a teacher in a class, I'm teaching a lesson. I wanna know, they understand or they don't. So let's use these two buttons. If the students understand, they just need to press the red button. The red light is ignited and the input is received in this app. It's known as Blink. You received in this app known as Blink. Now, if you don't understand, what would you do? Just press the blue button. Okay, blue light ignited and the input will be received in this app.
Okay.
Yes, vice versa, that's all.
Okay, sorry.
Now, you just don't need to use it for classroom evaluation. You can go beyond that. It's highly versatile. You can use it for, quizzes. Quizzes. Let me give you an example of quizzes. A teacher is asking a question. You've got A and B. You want to know? Okay, students answer A or B. Very simple. If you're answering A, press the red button. If you're answering B, press the blue button. Now, that input would be transferred, would be corresponded to this app. And the teacher would immediately receive the data. That's the example part. Now, Zain will explain about its technicality.
Thank you, Liva. Now, it's my turn to explain how does it really works. Firstly, we got two buttons here. As Liva said, it is for the students to press the buttons. And it works as a communicators. It also connected with the LED and also connected with the microcontroller ESP32. This ESP32 is the main like a brain functioning component for this IoT system. It is powered by power bank and also currently connected to Wi-Fi. So what does this do? This ESP32 will retrieve inputs from students by buttons, and then it will send to the teacher's device on the Blink app via Wi-Fi. So the teachers will know which student but the teachers won't know which student has gave feedback and has not. So we created this ID. This ID represent as identification of the chat. Therefore, like on this display, the teacher will know which chat has gave the feedback, which student have gave the feedback to the teacher's blinker. Also, this blinker, the teacher can install it on their devices from Google Play and App Store. That's all. Now I will pass to my friend Chen Wei to explain about furthermore.
Thank you, Zay. Okay. It's a fact that people nowadays produce a lot of rings. For example, they just buy or replace a new set of product, or for example, a chair. They just buy and replace it. And what happened to the broken one? Actually, they didn't do anything. They just throw it away. They didn't recycle it. They didn't do anything to fixing it or anything else. They just throw it away. And maybe put it on the storeroom and just put it aside. And this is a cause that the waste has been produced. It's not just a waste of resources and as you need to keep on making a new one. It's also a waste of money. Because people continuously to buy a new set of chair and replace it. So for us, we repurpose the waste to our universal seater. And it will save a lot of money and a lot of resources. As the waste, as the material that we use is waste. Waste we can find it anywhere. It's also very accessible and very easy to replace. For example, if our podium is broken, you can just replace it by finding another broken table and replace it. And if our table is broken, we can just find it from another broken table and replace it. And this action is not just reducing the resources, it also reducing the waste also. By creating the chair, it's also a reducing waste, but fixing it also a reducing waste. Isn't it wonderful? We have reduced double times of the waste by just in one chair. So I will let my efforts to explain about the conclusion.
Right, my thanks, Zenwei. Now, before I conclude, I would like to talk about the marketability of our innovation here. Now, our main targets for marketability would be primary, secondary, and tertiary school or educational institutions. Now, why do we pick these groups? It's mainly because that it's inevitable that these groups will end up with a certain amount of furniture waste or material waste. Now, what do they usually do with this waste? They dump it, they throw it away. It's waste. But I want to change your perspective here. I want to change your opinion on a pile of junk, a pile of scrap. I want you to see potential instead of junk. So what we're trying to do here is that this is supposed to be a shout out to other educational institutions that they should rethink the way that they deal with waste. Because why should you throw it away when you can use it to create something this wonderful and beneficial to the environment as well as other communities? And I would like to reiterate that this chair here, our universal seater, it is only taking on one variation of the many forms it could have taken on depending on the type of material waste you use to create it. For example, maybe in your school storage room or your school inventory room, there's only one table. You don't necessarily need to make it for both left and right handed people. The point is to reduce waste and recycle and repurpose and reuse wasted materials. So, in conclusion, we are aspiring to be an inspiration to other educational institutions to reuse anything that they can to save the planet in a sense. Therefore, from waste to grace. Thank you for listening.